Good morning, class. Welcome to our module 8, The Arts in Ancient Civilization. Before we go to this to the discussion, I just want to congratulate you in your previous module, which is the fundamentals in music. I know it's very short in terms of explaining the fundamentals in music, but I do hope also that you learn something most especially in the application of those fundamentals in music, like for example the right singing, the how you apply fundamentals in music in your singing abilities, your singing skills. Congratulations for those who accomplished the module 7 activities, thank you for the job well done. And now we're in the next lesson, which is the arts in ancient civilization. As an introduction to the arts in ancient civilization, let's just recall first the Stone Age. Ano ba yung Stone Age? We all know that stone, the people before in the prehistoric time used stone for their survival. And then nomadic, meron tayong tinatawag na nomadic. They go to another place just to survive. And then they use stone to hunt animals. They use stone to plant for their daily living. And it's very useful during that time that stone is very useful. And they use also to protect themselves in terms of enemies. In the prehistoric times, there are a lot of capabilities used to describe, because the people are very, very productive, and they are so good in making stone as the first one to use in their survival. So the technology, the development of technology arise in the Stone Age. They used also, through written records, there are some artifacts in the form, cave paintings. So ibig sabihin, pag nandun tayo sa cave, because it's in the nomadic time, sa Stone Age, ay ginamit nila yung stone just to draw, to paint something. And sculptures also would serve as the storytellers. So through sculptures. And then, ito yung introduction niya. And madi-discuss natin yung development. And then we're going to focus on the Egyptian art. After na ng Stone Age, let's focus on the Egyptian art class. Ancient Egyptian art is the painting, sculpture, architecture, and of course, other arts produced by the civilization in the Lower Nile Valley from 5000 before Christ to 300 Anno Domini, after death. Sa Egypt, ang dami-daming napakagandang artifacts na makikita dyan. Malalaman natin yan sa ating discussion. So, what are the characteristics in the Egyptian arts? Marami tayong mapapag-aralan in terms of the characteristics why Egyptian became most popular in terms of artifacts. Number one here is the keen observation and exact representation of actual life and nature. Strict conformity to a set of rules regarding representation of three-dimensional forms dominated the character and style of the art of ancient Egypt. Completeness and exactness. Highly religious. Idea of order. Clear and simple lines combined with simple shapes and flat areas of color. Figures were drawn to sizes. Ayan. Ang mga characteristics na ito ay makikita sa kanilang mga trabaho. Most especially sa religious. They have beliefs in terms of goddesses. At malalaman natin yan sa ating discussion. So, for example, pag tayo gumagawa ng arts, any kind of artworks, we need also to observe the characteristics because it's very important to give good character in terms of making a product. Kasi mas attractive sa mga tao kung makikita natin ang good characteristics. Nakikita yan sa trabaho. What are the subjects that we're going to learn in the Egyptian arts? First one is the gods and goddesses. Number two, the pharaohs. And number three is the actual life and nature. First, in the Egyptian arts class, we have the so-called architecture. Napakagaling nila sa architecture. Di ba pag sa secular courses, pinapag-aralan natin ang architecture. May mga student na pumupunta sa big universities just to learn something about architecture. For 4 to 5 years, meron pang naging 6 years sa mga nahihirapan just to finish architecture course. Sa Egypt, napakagaling nila kasi napapag-aralan nila in actual life and even in the nature. Ito yung mga ancient Egypt architecture. Tingnan natin. These are the pictures. So pag tinitingnan natin ang mga architecture work ng ancient Egypt ay nakakabighani. Napakaganda. Ano? Ito pa. Why was architecture important for the ancient Egypt civilization? Bakit napaka-importante ito sa kanila? Kasi they are doing this to praise their gods and goddesses. They are doing this for their religious beliefs. They are doing this because of the nature. Ano yung nakikita nila sa nature. And of course, they are doing this just to praise also their pharaohs, which is their king in the kingdom of Egypt. And so what? Mas importante dyan, nakikita natin dyan yung pag-praise nila sa goddesses nila. Ayan. Tingnan nyo. Ito yung mga Avenue of the Sphinx, Giza Sphinx, mga picture na to. At paano ba nila ginawa ito through the architecture? Napakagaling na it's out of stone and then a mountain and then they made it a big structure like that. Pag tinitingnan natin tong picture. Meron also tombs, yung libingan ng mga patay. For example, sa Egypt class, in the pyramid, meron tayong tomb dyan, and dyan nila inilalagay ang mga king nila, which is the pharaoh, pag namatay. Mga queen, mga prince, princess, mga taong matataas na posisyon, ano, pero ang pinaka-importante dito ay yung pharaoh nila, ano. So there are material used in doing this one. Meron material used, carved limestone statue for important tomb, destroyed mud bricks, ano, ganyan. Mga mud bricks, ginagamit nila yan. So, meron tayong kandito, website, tour guide. Pag ito, click nyo yung http://ancientegyptarchitecture.wordpress. Makikita nyo dyan yung architecture work ng mga Egyptian. So, you're going to visit that one for your activity. No, just click that this website. Now, number two is the pyramids. Noon, nung bata ako, gusto ko pumunta sa pyramid. Until now, hindi pa ako nakakapunta. Ano bang itsura ng pyramid? Ano bang itsura nito? So, yung bayaw ko, kasi he is an engineer, seaman engineer, marine engineer. And then, worldwide, pumupunta sila sa iba't ibang dako ng mundo. And then, napunta sila sa Egypt. At kinuwento niya sa amin kung ano yung itsura. Napakaganda daw, and there are stones na ginagawa ng mga tao doon. Binibili. And then, a big structure. Sobrang ganda. Ano, ano ba yung mga pyramid na kilala ninyo? Alam nyo ba yung mga pyramid na ito? First here is this one. Tingnan. Step pyramids. So, ano ba yung step pyramids? Sa word na step, yeah, it look like a step. But out of a big structure na pyramid na napakalaki. Ano ba yung gamit nito? So, pyramid complex. Djoser's step pyramid complex included several structures pivotal to its function in both life and afterlife. So, a pyramid was not simply a grave in ancient Egypt. Its purpose was to facilitate a successful afterlife for the king so that he could be eternally reborn. Ganun pala yung ginagamit nila. No? Ayan. So, ang pinakasikat na pyramid ay ito. The Great Pyramids of Giza. Di ba? Paano ba nila ginawa ito? how to imagine kung paano ba nila ginawa ito. So, the Great Pyramid of Giza is a huge pyramid built by the ancient Egyptians. It is the oldest of the seven wonders of ancient world and the only one to remain mostly intact. When it was built, it was 146.5 meters or 481 feet tall. So it was the tallest building in the world for over 3,800 years. So the pyramids of Giza are the largest and most recognizable pyramid structures in the world. So they were built to honor certain pharaohs of the fourth ruling dynasty of the Egypt during a period known as the Old Kingdom. So the Old Kingdom was the first great era of Egyptian civilization and lasted from 2686 to 2181 before Christ era. So nagawa na ito. Wala pa si Kristo, si Jesus Christ. Ano? Next is this one, the Great Sphinx. The Great Sphinx is among the world's largest sculptures. So measuring some 240 feet or 73 meters long and 66 feet high. It features a lion's body and a human head adorned with a royal headdress. Ayan. Ito yung Great Sphinx. Oo, ano. combination of human and a lion. Number three, well, tapusin na natin yung pyramid. Temples. Okay, temples. Tingnan yung temples. Ano bang itsura ng temples? Dami-daming mga rebulto out of stone. Yan yung temples nito. Ancient temples. Ito naman yung temples of Horus. Yan. Those are the temples built in the ancient Egypt. So, let's proceed to the crafts and sculptures. Yan. Picture. Tingnan ninyo. Yan. Ang gaganda. Paano ba nila ginawa yan? Sobrang galing ng mga Egyptian. At ito naman si Queen Nefertiti. Nefertiti. Ano? So, her reign was a time of tremendous cultural upheaval as Akhenaten reoriented Egypt's religious and political structures around the worship of the sun, god Aten. So Nefertiti is best known for her painted sandstone bust, which was rediscovered in 1913 and became a global icon of feminine beauty and power. Ano? Parang relatives niya si Cleopatra. Ano? Relatives niya daw. Ano? And she is a queen. Ito naman. Napakalaking crops and sculpture naman ito. Okay. Ito. Tutankhamun. Sino ba si Tutankhamun? Kilala niyo siya? Why is Tutankhamun so famous? The reason that Tutankhamun is so well known today is that his tomb containing fabulous treasures was found early this century in 1922. So by British archaeologists Howard Carter and Lord Carnarvon. So Davies had found a cup and other fragments bearing the name of Tutankhamen and his queen. Gold-plated ang sculpture na ito. Ito naman, pag pumupunta daw yung mga tao sa Egypt, merong mga ibinibigay. Ito yung mga stone crafts na ibinibigay as souvenir. And then, binibili nyo ito. Yung bayan ko, bumili siya ng mga ganitong artifacts. Ayan. Let's proceed to paintings. Ano, paintings din sa ancient Egypt. Ito. Ito yung mga paintings nila. Tingnan ninyo. Ang ganda. Ayan. Yan. Babae naman siya. Ano? Mga goddesses naman ng mga pinapakita nila. Ito. Ayan. Okay. Those are the paintings of ancient Egypt. At marami pa. Sample lang ang mga yun. Okay? Now, how to design an ancient Egyptian cartouche? Ano? Cartouche is an oval frame which surrounds the hieroglyphs to make up the name of an Egyptian god for royal person. Pag ini-illustrate, shows the three elements used to create a cartouche, the oval frame, the stun, and the rope which binds the other two together. Shows the three parts combined to form a basic cartouche frame. Shows the frame of the cartouche decorated with small hieroglyphs. Ito yung win nila ng pagsusulat. Ano? Gawin nyo yun, isusulat nyo yung pangalan nyo to cartouche. Okay? Ito, 1, 2, 3. Mga illustrations. So, adding your name to the cartouche. Okay, for example, Michael. Ayan. So hieroglyphs, what is hieroglyphs? Are word pictures which represent the sounds of the ancient Egyptian language. So in this cartouche, we have enclosed the hieroglyphs that spell out the sounds of the name Michael. So note that although there are seven letters in the name Michael, there are only four basic sounds, M-I-K-L. So therefore, we only need to use the hieroglyphs that represent those sounds. So a more detailed explanation on this translation process is given on our hieroglyphics pages. So you're going to search the hieroglyphs. So coloring the cartouche. Ayun. Okay. Ayan. Mga symbols, there are legends. And then through these legends, nakikita nyo, may sa baba niya ay may mga letters. Now, out of these letters and the legends, you are going to write your name as in your activity. Ito yung mga ancient Egyptian gods. So, ito, he is one of the oldest Egyptian gods. Ang pangalan niya is Anubis. He has the head of the jackal. He guides people to the afterlife. He watches over bodies while they are mummified. Si Anubis. Okay? Siya. O siya naman, si Isis. She is the sister and wife of Osiris. She is the mother of Horus. On her head, she wears cow's horns with the sun between them. Siya si Isis. Okay? God nila yan. Now, we have Bastet. Si Bastet. Who is Bastet? She sits on a throne. She is worshipped in the town called Bubastis. She is a goddess. She has the head of a cat. Ayan. Ito naman si Horus. He is the son of Isis and Osiris. He wears the double crown of Egypt. He is the sun god. He has the body of a falcon. Ayan. Ito naman si Osiris. He wears a white crown. He is the judge of the dead. He is the father of Horus. He is brother and husband of Isis. Ito naman si Thoth. He is the god of wisdom and writing. He carries a writing stick because he was ascribed to the gods. His head is an ibis bird. Sometimes he takes the form of a baboon. Okay. Ganon. Naman yung ancient Egyptian crowns. Mga picture na to. These are the crowns of Egyptians. Okay. How ancient Egypt influenced our lives today? This is our in your activity. How ancient Egypt influenced lives today? So, what plant did the Egyptian make paper out of? Ito yung activity. And then, please do the activity and submit it before the deadline. Okay. Thank you for listening, class, and have a good day, all of us. God bless.